If your Windows 11 or 10 is stuck on Please Wait screen, then you are at the right place, as we know how to fix it. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. After the computer starts, many system services start even before you log in to the computer. Services related to network, user interface, and more have to be ready by the time you reach your desktop. If you find that your computer screen is stuck on Please Wait screen, then this video can help you. Let's get started. Method 1. Force automatic startup repair. First, disconnect external drives, peripherals, etc. Wait for a minute and power up your system. Now, force shutdown and then power on your computer 3 times in a row. You can do this by first turning on the computer and then immediately pressing the power button again, but this time keep it pressed. It will turn off the computer. If you are using a desktop, you can also switch off from the power supply. Repeat these 3 times. The next time you start the computer, it will begin the automatic startup repair process, eventually launching the advanced recovery mode. Go to Troubleshoot and then select Advanced Options. Now click on the Startup Settings option and click on the Restart option. After the restart, press the F4 key. Once you have done that, you will boot into the safe mode. Method 2. Disable services. Once the computer boots into safe mode, you need to disable 3 services: Windows Error Reporting Service, Network List Service, and Network Location Awareness. To do this, open the Run utility using Windows Search. Type services.msc in the Run command box and press Enter. It will open the Windows Services Manager. Locate Windows Error Reporting Service and double-click to open the service properties. Stop it if the service is running. Change the startup type to disabled. Click Apply. Then follow the same for Network List Service and Network Location Awareness. Once done, restart the computer. Method 3. Rollback changes or perform system restore. If there was a change you made to the computer before the issue occurred, you might need to reverse it. If you can figure it out, it will be easy to fix the cause. If not, restoring your computer to its previous working state is best. Open the control panel using the Windows Search menu. Select the recovery option. Next, choose Open Restore and click on Next. Select a restore point. Once done, click on Next and then Finish to complete the process. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.